Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. For better or for worse, welcome back to another episode of my Shocking Shark film series. This episode centres around the 2017 comedy horror shark attack film, House Shark. This film was suggested to review by my resident Imperial advisor, so shout out to him, thank you very much. Without further ado, on with the review. The film opens with our protagonist, Frank Roosevelt, an ex-police officer, getting ready to go on a date for the first time in a while. His son Theo stops him from wearing his police badge to the date, and it's very melodramatic and stuff. But what I saw next shook me to my core. I kid you not, we were given a look at some BTEC version of a dating Facebook profile of Frank Roosevelt, as if someone is scrolling through it before transitioning to Frank's catfish of a date, melodramatic music and all. Get used to these being used throughout the film. Frank leaves Theo with the babysitter Betsy, which struck me as odd. Doesn't this kid look a little bit old for a babysitter? When Theo is put to bed, he tells Betsy that he's been hearing strange noises in the house, which he just responds to with a bunch of references to horror films that he is probably too young to watch, so wouldn't get. The scene then ends with some amazingly original, mysterious figure running past the camera shots. The following scene is even more original, with stalker POV shots and Betsy searching through the house. This shot doesn't even make any sense. The stalker POV and blue filter suggests it's an actual monster creeping up on her, so her turning around and nothing being there is absurd. They should have lost the filter, so while it would still be unimaginative and lazy, it could be excused for her just being paranoid for now. Betsy picks up Moby Dick, very subtle, and gets a snack from the fridge. She starts watching some crappy in-universe horror film, which I think is actually an alternate universe version of this film, very meta film, well done. Before we get some childish scatological humour while she is on the toilet, interspersed with more stalker POV shots. Next, while the shark is not shown on screen, it is heavily implied that she is being munched, much like the guy on the toilet from Three-Headed Shark Attack. Frank returns home, and hears Betsy screaming in the bathroom. He tries to help her, but he's too late. The effects for this aren't great and it's not very tense at all. Two months go by, and Frank and Theo have been living in their garden in order to escape the terror that occupies their abode, and of course, they have been living on tinned baked beans. Theo begins imitating his father's movements, and Frank responds to this in an equally unreasonable and unconvincing way.
What the hell, kid? Can't you see I'm going through hell here?
Dad, relax. Take a chill pill.
Theo's mum shows up to pick him up for their co-parenting time together, and she scolds Frank for his unsatisfactory living quarters, and threatens to sue for full custody unless he gets his act together. Which is fair enough. This is squalid. Frank starts crying with no tears, starts having a breakdown over the shark situation, before having this strange rant about it.
It's looking at me. And dressing me with its eyes, violating my every orifice with its sick, twisted, perverted mind.
I have no words. We then cut to a real estate agent named George who is being lectured by his boss, who is telling George to foreclose Frank's house. The boss goes on about being of Italian descent and threatens George's life, a blatant reference to the mafia, which is definitely a sign of a healthy professional relationship. Once George leaves, the boss starts maniacally laughing. You can't make this stuff up. Frank goes to the library and does research on shark attacks and homes, before coming home to see that his house is being shown to potential buyers. George suggests the couple go upstairs, much to Frank's protests. And while they look around, Frank confronts George about house sharks.
There's nothing wrong with this house.
No, there is. And I think I know what it is.
What's this?
Hilarious. The couple is pretty cringy, the woman's voice is pretty annoying, and the guy is in this horrible obvious wig. Don't get me started on the dialogue between these two.
The place where I make mad monkey love to you is right here in this living room.
Oh yeah, John?
The couple's dog goes missing, and then the shark attacks the couple while Frank and George fight outside. This girl then runs on screen.
Shark! Help, shark!
Absolutely hilarious. At the police station, Frank tells George he plans on contacting a house shark expert real estate agent called Zachary, and George laments about putting people in danger through his house viewings.
You know I had 3 families scheduled today?
It doesn't matter now, George.
One of them had kids. Kids, Frank. And these weren't just some ugly kids. I saw pictures. They were adorable.
This joke actually made me laugh. It was the pictures line, so I'll give the film props for that one bit. George's boss says he has hired a Darth Squanto to deal with the house shark. This very obvious parody of Darth Vader kicks Frank's ass before giving a lecture about the history of sharks and how they once roamed the land like buffalo. A child who is going to be adopted by the dead couple then kicks Frank's ass before Squanto ventures into the house to deal with the shark. He is, of course, promptly eaten by it. George's boss then has a meeting with his old business partner, Abraham, as in Abraham Lincoln, and he agrees to cut a deal with him. A walking German stereotype then arrives at Frank's tent and introduces himself as Zachary before giving Frank some food and inspecting the house. Yet they talk about killer vending machines while doing this. They discover John's body inside and then go to a bar for a drink. They meet Abraham there, who tells them he'll help them with the shark situation, as his limbs were bitten off by this exact shark yet sewn back on. They order a round of drinks and head to the house.
Bow, wench. A round of drinks for me and my new friends. And then we're gonna bag us a house shack.
I'll give you a bar, wench.
They board up the house to protect outsiders and enter it, and Abraham falls asleep in the bathtub. Zachary pulls out a weapon and his German accent wavers.
Yeah, I don't even like touching this.
And it appears that all three of them fall asleep eventually. Frank then wakes up and partakes in the classic stealth walk while inspecting the house, before going to the bathroom. The shark appears, and they're all backed into the bath, screaming like infants, and the shark suddenly retreats. Zachary then gets the idea to lure the shark to them, and they decide to dress Frank in a lady shark costume. Abraham then brings up this fancy sale event from 2004, when he first came across the dreaded house shark, who'd eaten his friend and co-worker, Tommy Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson!
And then attacked him. The shark appears and they squabble about it before it pulls out a laser gun and shoots at them.
It's just weird.
Zachary states that he wants the shark alive and Abraham shoots at it with his crossbow, which scares the shark off. They interrogate Zachary, who's faking his accent the whole time, and reveals the house shark was made due to an accident during an experiment that was meant to give him Spider-Man powers.
I mean, Spider-Man powers are cool and all. I prefer Mysterio myself.
Mysterio? Really?
Yeah. He's Spider-Man's greatest enemy.
Zachary suggests they expose the shark to some more plutonium, but Abraham knocks him out and decides to do it the old-fashioned way. They dress Zachary in the lady shark costume, and the three of them start singing sea shanties to attract the shark. It works, and while Abraham is attacked by the shark, Frank tries to stun it. This causes the shark to go after Zachary and pull him into the sink with him. This causes Zachary to hate the other two because they abandoned him. And when the house shark returns, George's boss appears out of a cupboard and begins beating the shark with a bat. George's boss then enters the shark and plans on blowing it up from the inside. This doesn't exactly go to plan, but Zachary blows himself out of the plumbing by plugging the drain, flooding the house, and the effect is unbelievably bad. Abraham and Frank swim through the house, and Frank fights Zachary in this weird underwater slow-mo scene while Abraham fights off the shark. Frank defeats Zachary, who shuffles away, before Frank unclogs the drain. The shark goes upstairs before falling asleep, and this gives Abraham the idea to train like the praying mantis, because it's the shark's mortal enemy according to him, so he can beat the shark up. Abraham begins to get eaten by the shark, and sacrifices himself in order to blow the shark up. Frank collects Abraham's pieces in order to sew him back together, again, and the film ends. That film was definitely somewhat entertaining, and it was definitely engaging. I wouldn't call it particularly funny, but it has the shock, absurdist, and running gag style of jokes that Family Guy has, so I'm sure someone probably finds it funny. I wouldn't say any of it's particularly scary or suspenseful, so I'd call it a black comedy parody film in comparison to a true comedy horror. Well, that's all for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, or leave any thoughts you had on today's video, as well as any suggestions you may have for future videos, in the comments down below. And as always, thanks for watching.